William E. Cochran, professors emeriti, faculty and staff, parents, distinguished guests, family and friends, it is my pleasure and honor to welcome you to the 84th annual commencement exercises of Southern College of Optometry. I know today's graduates join me in extending a special welcome to their family and friends, whose love and support have helped to make this day possible. Please join me in showing our appreciation. Today, the members of the class of 2017 become our colleagues. To all assembled here, thank you for joining us in celebrating the transitioning of these outstanding women and men into the profession of optometry. Graduation day is truly a day of great significance, not only for those receiving diplomas and certificates, but for the college and for the profession. As a whole, your class has demonstrated an extraordinary commitment to service, to the community, and to the college. We do expect great things from you and look forward to recognizing your accomplishments throughout your career as alumni. At this time, I would like to ask Shay Seckler, president of the class of 2017, to come forward and present the class address.
First of all, to our families, our friends, our teachers, and everyone supportive in our lives, thank you all so much. Regardless of how often you hear that, it's not enough. We really appreciate everything that you all have done to get us to this point, and we will continue to be grateful. We could not have asked for a better class to go through these 4 years with. We've all met our mark in one way or another, whether it was starring in the SCO workout video, I mean recruitment video, showing up to boards late, twice, or gracing the Snapchat world with Han. We've also learned a lot together, identity theft, axial myopia, and cultural competency. The bottom line is that we're so blessed to be here, becoming doctors, and I know we're all going to do amazing things with our lives. Congratulations, class of 2017.
Speaker today will be formally recognized later in the program with an honorary degree. Ms. Diane Rudner was raised here in Memphis, Tennessee, and is a graduate of East High School. In 1972, she received her Bachelor's of Arts degree in Psychology and Sociology, Phi Beta Kappa no less, from the University of Maryland. Her professional career began as a management trainee at Manufacturers Hanover Trust in New York City, where she became Vice President of Corporate Planning during her 11-year career. While residing in Tokyo, Japan in the late 1980s, she served on the board of the Tokyo Women's Club. Additionally, she chaired the American Orientations Committee and was a consultant to the Tokyo Community Counseling Service, the only English-speaking agency of its kind at that time. She returned to Memphis and in 1991 began Insight Associates, which specializes in corporate and strategic planning, family businesses, and partnerships. Throughout her career, Ms. Rudner has been an engaged member of our city. She takes an active interest in serving organizations and supporting projects and programs that have an impact on improving the services and opportunities for those in the Memphis community.
Members of the board, and graduating students. I'm so very grateful to accept this honorary doctorate. It's especially meaningful to me because the Southern College of Optometry is synonymous with success. It's well known as one of the leading institutions in optometric education and has been for over 85 years, and that's an amazing record. Dr. Reich is unusual in that he has such a breadth of experience in leading this institution, having been a researcher, an evaluator, and an administrator. didn't take very long to witness the friendly atmosphere on this campus, evidenced even by the faculty's coolest clothes. Yesterday, when I was there, a dress with the different versions of skeletons met me at the door. But on a more serious note, the faculty and your local alumni, many of whom have a long history with the college, are some of the most knowledgeable and prominent, representing almost every state in the country. The staff has spent much of their time and their lives in classrooms or meetings planning for the future success of this institution, and therefore your success. So whether they helped you with their moral support, academic support, or financial support, don't forget the people who were important to your journey. Remember to thank them, and then think about how you can be important to others in that same way in the future. And what better role model can there be than Marian Rosemore? She and her family are truly an inspiration to us all in living many of the lessons that are shared at graduation commencement ceremonies throughout the country. When I look out into this audience in the beautiful Cannon Center, I don't just see 130 graduate students on the stage full of pride. I'm also seeing the pride of your families here to witness your success, pride for the hard work, sweat, and tears that you've experienced to be here today. And in fact, I've heard about some of the fright many of you had when you were required to practice eye exams on your fellow students, or the zombie days of walking around campus with your diluted eight balls. But obviously, you all survived those experiences. SCO's mission, which I'm sure you know well, is to lead the profession by educating the best possible healthcare providers, promoting lifelong learning, and fostering a personal commitment to service. The first part of that mission continues to be achieved. Retention and graduation rates exceed 90%, and job placements exceed 95%. These statistics themselves are proof of the high standards that have been achieved at this college. Really remarkable. But its contributions can't just be measured in the numbers of degrees it doles out or the doctors it graduates. Its impact, as mentioned in its mission, is felt in many ways, and we in Memphis are the lucky beneficiaries of your hard work. Now, to be frank, Dr. Wright informed me that the jokes go over well at these ceremonies, but I don't think I'm selected for my stand-up comedian jokes. My children tell me I mess up the punchline every time I try. So I think it's better just to be myself and speak from what I know best and from my heart. At the Plow Foundation, we continue to receive a large number of grants every day. Every project is worthy, but there's never enough money to grant each request, and never enough grantors, local or national, to meet their needs. It can really be disheartening. The problems in our community and the nation are huge. Let me review just a few statistics that reveal the reality in which we are living. Did you know that 14% of adults in the United States over the age of 18 are functionally illiterate? That means they cannot read at the third grade level. And if we put this in another perspective, 130,000 adults in Memphis are unable to read well enough to fill out a job application, read to their own children, read road signs, or follow directions on a prescription bottle. One-third of children in Shelby County live in poverty. Translated another way, one in four children in Tennessee don't have access to regular meals and are literally at risk for hunger. As you know, nearly 80% of what a child learns is obtained visually. One out of four children in the United States will go back to school in the fall with an undetected vision problem, and that will surely interfere with their ability and speed of learning. 40 million individuals in the country are age 65 and older. That represents 13% of our total population, or one out of every eight Americans. By the year 2030, when you all will be in the prime of your careers, it's estimated that there will be 72 million senior citizens. So one area of emphasis that the Plow Foundation has been working on over the last 5 years has been that aging population. You might have heard it called the silver tsunami. Now, I can brag on our staff because they have done an incredible job on this subject, but neglected by local, state, and national agencies at all policy levels. Whether they relate to access to transportation or the funding of commissions that support quality of life care. Obviously, maintaining eye health has a huge influence on the solutions to many of those problems that I highlighted, whether they relate to poverty, education, or general health. But today is supposed to be a happy day for you graduates, so I certainly don't want to leave you depressed. Just the opposite. These numbers are meant to motivate you. There are a lot of wonderful nonprofit agencies and initiatives underway to help solve many of these problems, especially in Memphis. I'm always amazed by the generosity of people in the city. In fact, in the last survey conducted in 2016 by the Barner Group, Memphis was cited as the third most generous city in America. So obviously, there's not a shortage of individuals or groups stepping up to the plate. But from my many years working in the philanthropic field, what I think we're missing the most is the involvement and leadership of people like yourselves. Your knowledge creates a different perspective, a unique understanding of some of these problems, and therefore a more creative solution to confront future challenges. If we just focus on eye health and how vision challenges determine the quality of life for all populations, you graduates know better than others how it can determine a person's level of education. Their mental health, such as feelings of isolation, anxiety, or depression, where exactly they can live or work, and how independent they will be. This information should impact the policies, treatments, and solutions to many of society's day-to-day problems. So your input will be so important as a voice in architecture, for example, safety of home design, education, such as what are appropriate visual aids to use, or health interventions via early detection of diabetes, glaucoma, or cataracts. Most people who have the prestige of being doctors seem to have automatic clout. And for that very reason, we need you to contribute your knowledge to serve on nonprofit advisory committees, school boards, county commissions, national trade organizations. Your expertise in education will allow you to make a huge impact. Optometry is a service-oriented profession, and your college already gives you a great role model for instilling empathy. It's well known for its community outreach through its clinic in Memphis, which has already provided annually over $1.5 million of charitable care to the community, and reaching over 50,000 patients in just the eye clinic alone. SCO has provided free screenings and donated free glasses this year to over 800 elementary school students in just the Achievement School District. It sponsors special events like a day at the zoo to educate children and parents together about the importance of eye health. So no matter how far from this school you find yourself in the coming year, if you're unsure what avenue of service you want to pursue, just consult the staff or the board of SCO. They represent a treasure trove of service and can be a great source of contacts and information for you to align your service possibilities. They represent advisors to educators, senior services, sports management. They provide input into legislative policy and public health initiatives, treatment of trauma, preschool development. Their reach is broad and their net is huge. So just think what difference you can make individually or collectively in whatever community you decide to call home. You can solicit your fellow students, your future employees, or your patients and their families. Over the years, I found that the most important part of my education wasn't measured in any exam or essay. And I don't want to burst your bubble, but in a few years, your resume will probably just be words on a piece of paper. But what will be measured is your ability to make a difference in the communities that you serve. So as you embark on your next journey, I sincerely hope service will be a top priority. Your quality of life will be determined by building a resume of who you want to be, a story about your purpose, not your title, Doctor of. One of the favorite quotes I like to use is from Maya Angelou, who wrote, "You shouldn't go through life with a catcher's mitt on both hands. You need to throw something back." Frankly, the future of Memphis and America will depend on it. Thank you so much. God bless you.
a time, the Board of Trustees recognizes individuals who have rendered distinguished service to the profession of optometry and the public by awarding the honorary degree, Doctor of Humane Letters. Ms. Diane Rudner has been a board member of the Plow Foundation, a private philanthropic organization, since 1990 and chairman of its board since 1997. The Plow Foundation makes grants in Memphis and Shelby County, serving a wide variety of needs such as healthcare, families and seniors in crisis, public education, homelessness, arts and culture, and public safety. Throughout her career, she has been active in the Memphis civic community. She has served as chairman of both Arts Memphis and Wonders, the International Culture Series. She was also vice chair of the Memphis Shelby County Crime Commission. In 2002, she was selected for the Harvard Kennedy School of Government's inaugural class of Women and Power Leadership in a New World. Ms. Rudner currently serves on the boards of Memphis Tomorrow, Overton Park Conservancy, SunTrust Bank of Memphis, and Argent Financial Group. In recognition of her contributions to the community, she has been honored as a recipient of an honorary doctorate of humane letters from Lemoyne Owen College, and in 2013, she received the Algernon Sidney Sullivan Award from Rhodes College. Subsequent to approval by the Board of Trustees of Southern College of Optometry, it is my pleasure to recommend Ms. Diane Rudner for the degree, Doctor of Humane Letters. On your second honoree serves as an example of an individual who has been steadfast and generous in her support of the profession of optometry. Marianne Goldstein Rosemore has a long history of involvement with optometry, which began in 1946 while supporting her husband, Frederick Rosemore, a World War II Army Corps veteran, through optometry school at Southern College of Optometry. And for Ms. Rosemore, optometry is husband, brother, brother-in-law, daughter, and seven grandchildren have all earned the Doctor of Optometry degree. Early in their marriage, Mrs. Rosemore became a driving force in establishing a culture of philanthropy within the family. As the Rosemores' financial success grew, so did their desire to give back. Mrs. Rosemore's personal commitment to philanthropic giving comes from her faith and her understanding of the tenet, to whom much is given, much is required. Dr. and Mrs. Rosemore shared a special relationship in that all decisions were made with the advice and consent of the other. In the mid-1980s, a time that SCO had little alumni support, the Rosemores set an example by making one of the first endowed gifts to the college. It was Mrs. Rosemore who realized the impact that contribution could have in helping the college be seen as an organization worthy of support. Through the Rosemore Family Foundation, she has continued to support not only SCO, but a variety of optometric institutions and organizations, scholarships, research funding, and capital improvements. The Rosemore Family Foundation has supported the Optometric Extension Program, the Optometry Cares Foundation of the American Optometric Association, the American Academy of Optometry, the New England College of Optometry, the University of Houston College of Optometry, the Indiana University School of Optometry, and the University of Alabama at Birmingham School of Optometry. Marion Rosemore has set the standard for supporting optometric education. Additionally, Mrs. Rosemore's philanthropic giving extends outside of optometry to support more than 25 organizations that Subsequent to the approval by the Board of Trustees of Southern College of Optometry, it is my pleasure to recommend Ms. Marion Rosemore for the degree Doctor of Humane Letters.
Upon your recommendation, by the virtue of the authority vested in Southern College of Optometry by the State of Tennessee, I hereby confer on Marion Goldstein Rosemore the honorary degree Doctor of Humane Letters with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto.
Graduating class of 2017 have performed in a meritorious manner, successfully completing the optometric curriculum at Southern College of Optometry, and while great pride in these accomplishments should be shared by the graduates, families, friends, and distinguished faculty of the college, there are those graduates who have achieved at a distinguished level which tradition names as the salutatorian and valedictorian of the class. By definition, the salutatorian of the class has achieved the second highest cumulative grade point average, and the valedictorian the highest cumulative grade point average during the curriculum at Southern College of Optometry. It is my pleasure to present to you the salutatorian of the graduating class of 2017. Megan G. Williams, please come forward at this time to receive a plaque engraved in your honor as salutatorian of the class of 2017. It is now my distinct pleasure to announce the valedictorian of the class of 2017. Would Derek B. Hennig come forward at this time to receive a plaque recognizing this honor? Latinized honors to acknowledge outstanding academic achievement while enrolled in the professional program at Southern College of Optometry were earned by members of the class of 2017. Those graduates having a cumulative grade point average of between 3.4 and 3.59 will receive the recognition of graduating cum laude. These individuals are wearing white honor cords designating this honor. Additional members of the class of 2017 are graduating magna cum laude, signifying a cumulative grade point average of between 3.6 and 3.79. Those graduating magna cum laude are wearing silver honor cords. Students graduating with a cumulative grade point average of at least 3.8 are accorded the honor of graduating summa cum laude. A gold and blue honor cord signifies this distinction. Those graduating with honors will be individually recognized as they are announced to receive their hoods and diplomas. Will the candidates for the Doctor of Optometry degree please rise? Dr. Carrie Leibowitz will now come forward and administer the optometric oath. Degree candidates, please remain standing once the oath is completed.
All doctors of optometry. optometry in attendance please also rise and join me in the recitation of the optometric oath, which is printed in the center of your program. With full deliberation, join with me. I freely and solemnly pledge that I will practice the art and science of optometry faithfully and conscientiously and to the fullest scope of my competence. I will uphold and honorably promote by example and action the highest standards, ethics, and ideals of my chosen profession and the honor of the degree, Doctor of Optometry, which has been granted me. I will provide professional care for those who seek my services with concern, with compassion, and with due regard for their human rights and dignity. I will place the treatment of those who seek my care above personal gain and strive to see that none shall lack for proper care. I will hold as privileged and inviolable all information entrusted to me in confidence by my patients. I will advise my patients fully and honestly of all which may serve to restore, maintain, or enhance their vision and general health. I will strive continuously to broaden my knowledge and skills so that my patients may benefit from all new and efficacious means to enhance the care of human vision. I will share information cordially and unselfishly with my fellow optometrists and other professionals for the benefit of patients and the advancement of human knowledge and welfare. I will do my utmost to serve my community, my country, and humankind as a citizen as well as an optometrist. I hereby commit myself to be steadfast of this, my solemn oath and obligation.
Everyone except the graduates may be seated. President Reich, upon the recommendation of the faculty of Southern College of Optometry, I present the candidates for the degree of Doctor of Optometry. They have pursued their prescribed studies diligently, have passed all required examinations, and have demonstrated commendable proficiency in the art and science of optometry. I, therefore, recommend that the degree Doctor of Optometry be conferred upon them at this time.
Upon your recommendation, and by the virtue of the authority vested in Southern College of Optometry by the State of Tennessee, I hereby confer on those recommended the degree Doctor of Optometry with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto.
Graduates may be seated.
Dr. Kevin Raymond Adair Jr. Cumpade. Dr. Gabe M. Alsawady. Dr. Leslie Owens, summa cum laude.
Ayushi. Amen. Dr. David Bradley Anders, assisting President Reich in the awarding of Brad's diploma, and in honor of his late father, Dr. Bud Anders, SEO class of 1978, is Sherry Anders Randall, Brad's mother. Dr. Sarah Elizabeth Anderson. Lindsay Jordan Armagon. Dr. Matthew Harris Armentrout. Dr. Celeste Angel Baker, summa cum laude. Assisting President Reich in the awarding of Celeste diploma are Dr. Cynthia and Joseph Baker, SEO class of 1983, Celeste parents. Dr. Celia R. Baker, summa cum laude. Dr. Timothy Edwin Bass, summa cum laude. Dr. Zachary Baumhawk, magna cum laude. Dr. Laura O'Kemper, magna cum laude. Tyler Ross Boone, summa cum laude. Dr. Hai On Bui. Dr. Emily Knox Caldwell. Dr. Rebecca Jean Callahan. Bradley Calvin Colliser. Dr. Whitney P. Caro, cum laude. Dr. Taylor G. Chestnut, magna cum laude. Tiffany Morin Chin. Dr. April Chu. Cameron Waters Kleiner, summa cum laude. Dr. David Warren Cloakley III. George Christopher Cora. Dr. Christine Marie Craig. Dr. William Parker Dodd, Assistant President Reich in the awarding of William's diploma, is Dr. John Dodd, Southern College of Optometry class of 1981, William's father. Dr. Christopher Charles Dowdy. Dr. Kara Marie Eby, cum laude. Dr. Emily Kate Eisenhower, cum laude. Dr. Jennifer Alimalu. Dr. Taylor Nicole England. Caroline Khalil Fogelman, summa cum laude. Dr. Inga Liliana Fors, assisting President Reich in the awarding of Inga's diploma and in honor of her late father, Dr. Al Fors, Southern College of Optometry, class of 1969 and longtime SEO faculty member, is Marcus Fors, Inga's brother. Dr. Timothy Hunter Fouch, assisting President Reich in the awarding of Hunter's diploma is Dr. David Fouch, Southern College of Optometry, class of 1987, Hunter's father. Dr. Douglas Robert Bruin. Dr. Alexander Joseph Garibay. Dr. Peyton E. Glass. Dr. Rebecca Ann Goad. Dr. Jared Luke Griffiths. Dr. David Charles Hava. Dr. Jordan Lee Hamrick, summa cum laude. Dr. Stacy M. Farwell, magna cum laude. Dr. Rebecca Marin Hout. Dr. Eric Andrew Henderson. Dr. Sarah Paige Henderson. Derek Brian Hennig, summa cum laude. Christopher Herring. Dr. Catherine Marie Hogan, cum laude. Dr. Michael E. Hollins, Jr. Dr. William Zachary M. Bowden. Alex Mitchell Jackson, magna cum laude. Dr. Alyssa Wooden Jackson. Jensen. Dr. Patrick C. Jones. Dr. William James Calvin Jones. Dr. Erin Alyssa Kine, summa cum laude. Dr. Zachary David Lancaster. Dr. Amanda Michelle Lapp. Dr. Maria Anna Mavali, cum laude. Dr. Stephen M. LeBlanc, Assisting President Reich in the awarding of Stephen's diploma is Dr. Cornell LeBlanc, Southern College Optometry class of 1977, Stephen's father. Dr. Tyler Dean LeBieber. Dr. Nathan Ray Light. Dr. Stacy Alma Looper. Dr. Jacob David McDonald. Dr. Mark Rosaka Manchin. Dr. Lauren Marie McCain. Dr. Mason Douglas McCain. Dr. Justin Lee McElroy. Dr. Max E. Melberg, cum laude. Assistant President Reich in the awarding of Max's diploma is Dr. Ed Melberg, Illinois College of Optometry class of 1981, Max's father. Dr. Joanna Marie Makatua Miranda. Dr. Hunter J. Morgan, magna cum laude. Dr. Tyndall Dawkins Morrison. Dr. Courtney Fawton Morrow. Dr. Michelle Rose Mosco, cum laude. Assistant President Reich in the awarding of Michelle's diploma are Drs. Billy Mosco, Southern College of Optometry, class of 1978, and Dr. Sharon Berger Mosco, SEO, class of 1980, Michelle's parents. Dr. Benjamin Grant Nielsen. Dr. Daniel Lynn Nielsen, magna cum laude. Dr. Lei Fawn Nim. Dr. Jacob Daniel Norhus. Dr. Ashley Elise Oaks, magna cum laude. Dr. Matthew Ryan Page, magna cum laude. Dr. Taylor Ray Hasley, magna cum laude. Dr. Sarah Elizabeth Petska, summa cum laude. Dr. Sean Francis Pennard, Assistant President Reich in the awarding of Sean's diploma, is Dr. Frank Pennard, Southern College of Optometry, class of 1987, Sean's father. Dr. Helena Nicole Portner. Clinton Roger Presswich, summa cum laude. Dr. Anna Rose Freer. Dr. Quattro Mora Elizabeth Prendiz, summa cum laude. Dr. Ibrahim Sadadeen Khatan. Dr. Sarah Nicole Ravitch, cum laude. Dr. Adam Quinn Rectangle, cum laude. Dr. Kevin Andrew Rice, summa cum laude. Assisting President Rice in the awarding of Kevin's diploma is Dr. Stephen Rice, University of Missouri, St. Louis, class of 1987, Kevin's father. Dr. Bradley Joseph Richland. Assisting President Rice in the awarding of Brad's diploma is Dr. Stephen Richmond, Southern California College of Optometry, class of 1983, Brad's father. Dr. Emily Claire Ridge. Dr. Lauren Dallas Rigsby, cum laude. Dr. Benjamin G. Roach, summa cum laude. Dr. Lisa Elizabeth Roach, summa cum laude. Dr. Sarah Ann Rohr. Dr. Siobhan Rothstein, summa cum laude. Dr. Christina Sandoval, magna cum laude. Dr. Shea A. Seckler, magna cum laude. Dr. Roxanne Sinichal, magna cum laude. Dr. Lauren Michelle Suter, cum laude. Dr. Evan Jared Shields, cum laude. Dr. Caitlin Nicole Short. Dr. Keith Sladen, cum laude. Dr. Andrew T. Smith, summa cum laude. Dr. Kayla Landon Smith, magna cum laude. Dr. Jacob L. Stahlbaum. Dr. Stephanie Michelle Stanley. Dr. Jenna Michelle Stephan. Dr. Tiffany H. N. Tang. Dr. Sydney Dunn Taylor. Dr. Matthew H. Thibodeau. Dr. Danielle LeBron Thompson, cum laude. Joshua D. Tinsley. Doctor and now Officer Stephen Thomas Tipton, magna cum laude. Dr. Brian Trong. Dr. Sandra Anna Trivis, cum laude. Dr. Sarah Louise Rotzis, magna cum laude. Dr. Matthew G. Walker. Dr. Lisa Wang, cum laude. Dr. Whitney Caitlin Delane Watson, summa cum laude. Dr. Zachary R. Weinberg, assisting President Reich in the awarding of Zach's diploma, is Dr. Daniel Weinberg, Southern College of Optometry class of 1984, Zach's father. Dr. Mark Wells. Dr. Jennifer Allen Wilcox, cum laude. Dr. Megan Greer Williams, summa cum laude. Dr. Lindsay Marie Wood, magna cum laude. Dr. Justin Corey Zampella. Please join me in congratulating the class of 2017.
so much for coming. We're just going to take a few pictures up here after the recessional, and then we'll be right after.